I'm Ryan.
I'm Emily.
And I met you guys at this rest stop, and I don't know what town we're in, but we're somewhere.
In Southern Oregon.
In Southern Oregon. And I saw you guys pull up in this, and my husband and I were immediately excited. So how long have you guys been traveling in this?
Like 3 weeks, about. We came from Ohio.
And we're in Southern Oregon, so that's actually really far.
Yeah.
Did you hit any bad weather?
We had a couple flash flood warnings that freaked us out a little bit. Had a couple of run-ins with some serious snow in a mountain. I've never seen this much snow. We were actually in Oregon last night. There was like 15, 16 feet of snow on the side of the road. Couldn't see anything. It was terrible. We ended up turning around and...
Yeah, it was crazy. Yeah,
it was rough.
So you guys look young. Can I ask how old you guys are?
24.
23.
Okay, so is this your first time doing something like this?
Yes.
Yeah, we're kind of on a mission exploring what we want to do in life, and this was kind of our first step. You know, we're not really sure what direction we're headed, but we're kind of looking into alternative lifestyles, so we felt like this would be a nice trip to kind of like guide us in the right direction. So we've met a lot of really cool people along the way.
Yeah, definitely.
We met a nice guy from Argentina.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's far.
He came really far. He was in the Grand Canyon. It was really cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, and he offered if we're ever in Argentina, we can stay with him. So it's really cool.
Immediate friends.
Maybe we'll go to Argentina now. You never know.
That's awesome.
So have you guys ever traveled in any RV type thing before? Any RV experience? Any travel experience?
No. I've just always wanted to do... I've always wanted to like convert a bus. I've always wanted to do a big bus, but it would have been hard. This was more than I could. I already bit off more than I could chew with this and the amount of time that I had. But she actually went to study abroad in Florence for a semester a few months ago. And while she was gone, we just decided that this would be something I could spend my time with while she was gone. And then we'd leave when she came home, and we did. And now we're gone.
So how long did it take you to do this?
All of it in like 4 months.
Yeah. About 4 months.
But I mean, like, obviously, like, all of that work was spread out a lot, like, over those 4 months.
I worked during those 4 months as well, like, full time. So, like, it wasn't like I just dedicated 4 months to this, but it took a lot of time and a lot of work. But honestly, it's really anyone who wants to do this at all, it's definitely doable. There's a billion videos out there to watch. I mean, there's plenty of resources. It's really easy to do, and it's not that expensive. It's really not. It's doable.
So how much planning, I mean, was this like when she was abroad, you were like, hey, let's do this, and it kind of was like that?
We decided we were going to do it before she left, and I bought the bus like two weeks after she flew out to Italy, and then was done almost when she came home.
That's awesome. So where did you guys live before this?
We currently lived in, we had an apartment in Kent, which is where we both went to school.
Got Kent, you. Ohio, yeah. Not Kent,
yes.
Washington.
Right.
Kent, Ohio.
I went to Kent State, so.
Got ya. Really okay, so what does your family think about you guys doing this?
They don't mind. My family was very supportive. This bus was parked in my parents' front yard for 4 months while I did all the work, and I messed up my parents' garage terribly doing it, and they were very supportive. Very supportive. They both helped me out a lot.
Did you guys just work and then save to do this little trip?
Yes. Work and save to do this. And then the reason we're doing this is because we're trying to figure out a way that we can, like she was saying a second ago, live a little bit differently. See if this is the way we want to live, or see if we find a place we'd like to live, or a lifestyle, something different, you know, and see what's out there.
So how long is this trip going to be?
Probably another month.
2 weeks or...
month or two probably for this trip, just because what we saved, and then we're gonna go home and just discuss it and figure out what we're gonna do next.
We're thinking we went to Hawaii last year around this time, a little before, like mm-hmm. December, and it was like a work exchange program.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it was like honestly probably the best month of my life.
It was really cool.
I think we're talking about, you know, maybe going back down to Hawaii.
So you have a travel bug, definitely.
Yeah, I would say so. Especially
cool.
This one. Especially
that's
this
very
one.
Cool.
And I'm always down to try
we'll
new
see
things.
What happens.
But if we were discussing if we went to Hawaii, maybe even starting like a kind of a business for like work out there and doing something out there while we work on a farm to have a place to stay. So just like a couple of different ways. There's lots of ways to make money too, and you guys are familiar with that as well. But there's lots
work
of ways
camping,
to make
right?
money. Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So are you guys planning on staying at a campground anytime, or where are you guys staying at on the road?
We've been mostly staying at national parks and Walmart parking lots, which, by the way, I honestly can recommend. You can look at the reviews on the Walmarts. If it's a good Walmart, it's definitely going to be a good parking lot. We've probably stayed in about 15 so far, haven't had one hiccup.
It's not the most glamorous, but it's sometimes not. When you just are driving like long stretches, it's like good safe place.
Yeah,
you and can wake up and there's like a bathroom.
That's the biggest thing for me, like when we're both getting tired and it's getting dark and it's getting late and I'm in an area I'm not familiar with and I'm worried about me and her being safe, like it's an area I can pull off and know we're not going to get messed with. At least there might be some other people around. It's just the area where I feel better than like pulling down some random side street and maybe you're going to get harassed by the cops or the people who live there or who, whatever, you know. It's just a safe place and I honestly have felt pretty good there so far.
Ditto, we do that a lot too.
I've had good Walmart
experiences. We met some people who said they were boondocking, but they were in a full-size bus.
They had three kids.
Because we just, like, how do you boondock in a full-size, like, bus? He's like, we just pull off on a road somewhere and we're like, you know, we drive lots. Like, I haven't seen a single road where I'm like, I don't think a full-size bus would be noticed right there.
You know, I think what it comes down to is you'll probably be all right, but for me, it's worth the sense of security. Even though it's not as glamorous in a Walmart as it is on some empty road where you might have a nice view, it's just nice to know that I'm allowed to be there, A, and B, that I'm a little bit safer and protected, and there's resources there if I need it. I probably have Wi-Fi or 3G or something near the Walmart, but in the middle of nowhere, we haven't had internet, and if something goes wrong, I'd rather be in a Walmart parking lot where I can make a 911 call than in the middle of nowhere with nothing.
Right. So are you guys planning to just like loop? What's your plan to loop back around back to Iowa or Ohio?
Ohio.
We're going down to Utah. And so we're going to hit up like all of the national parks in Utah and then back through Colorado. We really liked like the Denver area. So we're going to like maybe spend a week or two there and then head home.
Gotcha. Very cool. So does your bus have any hookups?
It does not have any hookups. It's actually pretty
It's almost self-sufficient.
I can charge my batteries from the alternator on the bus while the bus is running. I have two really huge, nice batteries. Definitely worth the investment. I feel great. They never die. That they charge when the bus is running and they charge from the solar panels all day, and we haven't had a problem in the 3-4 weeks we've been gone.
That is awesome. Yeah. So do you guys just carry water in if you need it?
We've got 15 gallons for our sink, and that lasts
like
us about
a
week. And then we have a 7.5 gallon tub for our drinking water.
So how do you pump in the water for your sink?
I have a electric pump and it's self-fed. So when I open my pump, it just comes out. It's actually really cool. If anyone's looking into doing this, the pumps are kind of expensive. And what I have, my system makes a little bit of noise, but it was really cheap. It comes with a 15 gallon tank and it's like they're meant for the back of like ATVs or something. If you wanted to like spray pesticides on your crop, it's like it comes with the pump already and the hose already with it, with a on-off. So it's got a 15-gallon tank and a pump already in the thing. You just got to find a spot to put it in under your living area and then run the hose right to the bottom of your sink. It's a breeze. It comes with the container and the pump. It like knocked out three steps in one. Because I was like running low. I was like running short on time, waiting for the pump to get here from Amazon. It was going to take time. And then I just bought this at Tractor Supply, $75. My whole plumbing system for my sink, $75.
Nice. So let's get a tour.
For sure.
So here, we used to call this toilet closet because he wanted to put a toilet in it, but we decided to go the alternate route and just use it for storage. So it's mostly like clothes and like any of our excess things, but this is our drinking water up here. So that's like obviously like a potable water, but that we sometimes use like, you know, alternate water sources that like we wouldn't typically drink from, but like we use it for dishes and stuff, so no big deal.
Got ya.
And then we have a fridge here. I guess I can roll it out and show you. So it rolls out.
Oh my gosh, I've never seen one like that.
Yeah.
That's a 12 volt thermoelectric fridge. They're really great. I recommend them to anyone who's looking into doing this. They really save on electricity. When this is running, I use about 6 watts. And it doesn't even run all the time. It probably kicks on for about 15 minutes every 35, 40 minutes. It uses pretty much next to no energy. And if I do happen to lose battery for any amount of time, because it's a thermoelectric cooler, the thermo part means it's insulated like a regular cooler, it'll stay cold for a long amount of time. It also has temperature settings, and you can adjust the temperature to freeze or any temperature you want. So if you want to use it as a deep freezer to store food for long periods of time, you totally can. I happened to get this on Craigslist actually for $100, and they retail for $499, $500. Definitely, I would suggest using Craigslist. I mean, always look around, change the mile radius on your Craigslist settings, or Facebook Marketplace is really good now. Change the mile radius to even 100 miles. It's worth the drive. I saved $400. It's worth the drive, and it's great. And people are happy when they sell their stuff too. It works well for everybody. I definitely recommend Craigslist. Almost everything in here I got secondhand or used, other than, like I said, the batteries were worth it to spend for me. But other than that.
So this is what it looks like inside. Wow, that is so much space.
Yeah, it's pretty big. Space,
that is amazing. That is amazing that that runs off 12 volts.
Okay. So if you point your camera up, you can see like the cedar. He actually, that's like kind of reclaimed wood. It's from his dad's porch. They were building a new porch, and so they like took all the scrap wood and sanded it down.
They planed it all down to half an inch and then put it up on the quarter of an inch, actually. And then
it's
put it
beautiful.
Up on the roof.
And it looks treated. This, it looks really good.
Yeah, and this wood here, all the wood in here is actually from the deck. It's all reclaimed wood. And I happen to have access to a lot of it because we were, like my girlfriend just said, tearing up the deck. However, like I said, Craigslist, there's so many people who are trying to sell junk wood. And it might look like junk, but if you want to spend like a couple of hours with it and work with it, it'll look really pretty and add character to it. And be cost next to nothing and look like $1 million. And you'll feel good about it when you're done. Is it this catalytic safety heater? It runs off a 20-pound propane tank that I actually just keep under there. But this heater back here will keep this whole thing as warm as I want it to.
Oh my gosh, that's huge.
Doesn't release any gas. I have carbon monoxide and a propane monitor in here. It's always been fine, never anything. Keeps it warm in here, and one propane tank will last me a month. One 20-pound propane tank will last me a month. You can exchange them anywhere. Great heater.
Dang, great that's heater. Cool.
That's something else I would recommend buying new, that I did buy new and I learned the hard way. I bought a used one on Craigslist. It was my one bum Craigslist buy, and it's going to happen, but don't let it discourage you. It was my one bum Craigslist buy that apparently the catalytic pads can get saturated with dust over time if they're not covered. And I didn't know this when I bought it, and it didn't ignite well and didn't work for me. So I got a new one, but it's definitely great. I would definitely consider buying one of those as well to heat a small space like this. They're very safe. I was worried about not waking up because I had a propane heater going in here. Like, some people say they use those little Mr. Buddy things, but I've read horror stories about those not working. So like, this is just, I felt good. I want to be able to sleep in peace.
Right. So what size bed is that?
It's
almost a double.
It's 50 inches wide. So a double is 52. So it's almost 50 inches wide. And it is pretty much exactly six. It's like 6'1" lengthwise. So I can barely fit. And if you notice, I can't stand in here. You can stand. She can stand. It's about 5'10" in here. And I'm like
6 foot.
I'm like 6 foot. So I'm not a full stand in here. But it's still great. Originally, before I got this, I was toying with the idea of buying a van, and I would have had way less space in a van other than a Sprinter van, but Sprinters were just a little out of our price range. However, they're also really great for anyone looking to do this. Sprinters are also a really good option, but this struck a chord with me because this bus was diesel and I really wanted a diesel as well. So that's nice.
Do you want to show us the little sink?
Yeah. Sure. So this is our sink. It runs.
I said it makes a noise.
Mm.
But so under here, that's just where the water is collected, right there.
Oh, I see.
And I just take that out and dump it. I also have another hose if I want to let it go right out, but we haven't done it yet because I don't want to just. I don't feel comfortable dumping water wherever I am, even though it's just soap water. There's no toilet. Mm-hmm. There's no anything. It's just soap dishes. No trash. But we try to be cognizant of where we dump the water. Not because it's bad, but just because I don't want to mess with, I don't know who we're going to meet. People are going to be weird about certain types of things. I know it's safe to dump, but someone sees you dumping water, they're going to assume it's bad things. So I just like to be careful about where we dump it. I wish I could show you the reservoir, but it's under here right now. And I can't pull all this up with all this stuff on it. And all my battery stuff is also located under here. If I pulled the bed up, it's accessible, but like I said, that would be too much of a stressful right now, but everything fits in here. We have ample storage like under the bed as well for stuff. I have another propane tank under the bed as well for extra propane tanks, pots, pans, more clothes, cooking stuff.
How do you cook if you have pots and pans?
We have like
I just bring out one of these little camp stoves right here. Oh. Set it up.
So how often does that happen?
Open up a window every day. This is our daily cooker. Breakfast and dinner. We had eggs this morning. We'll probably have pasta tonight. And it's been really well. Worked really well, actually. It's nice because I did think about building one in. If I had a little bit bigger of an RV or a space to work with, I probably would have. But it's just, I didn't want to have...
This kind of makes the most out of what...
I didn't want to lose space counter space with a permanent stove. So I figured it'd be better to put it away and bring it out when I want to use it. And then we could have more space for our stuff.
Very cool. So I know that we have talked about it, but... If you guys consider making a YouTube channel, your link I will put down in here.
For sure.
So yeah, definitely.
You guys, I know a lot of people ask me if you guys have a YouTube channel, and I'm telling you guys right now, they don't, but if they do, the link will be put under here, guys.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely. We'll get on that right away.
We talked about it because, you know, like, it took him a really long time, and he watched a ton of YouTube channel videos, like, while he was building this, so he wants to like give back to the community of viewers who would be interested in doing something like this, who would also...
This would have been impossible without everyone else's videos.
Yeah.
It would have been impossible. I would have never been able to stay tuned because
we might be coming up with some videos on how you can do something like this for yourself.
Right now, we left in a hurry. Eventually there'll be like a stand here for the bikes to actually go on, but this is also really crucial for us to have all of our things with us and have enough space.
Did you build this yourself?
Inside this, I actually had a friend of mine who does welding for a living weld this together. And it just goes right into the hitch receiver and bolts on to the frame.
It's huge.
But
it gives us that extra storage.
Put stuff on top, and it gives us this extra storage protected.
You'll see how much room is in here. It's crazy.
Underneath. If you can get something off the back for your stuff to keep it out of the bus, it's great. Like, this whole thing is full.
Mostly camp stuff.
Full of stuff like our camping equipment, our chairs, some fluid for the bus if it needs, if I need to clean the fuel injectors. Our dirty laundry is actually in here right now because we haven't been to a laundromat yet, and I don't want to keep it in the bus. Tools, in case I need to fix things. Everything is under here. Our camping backpacks are way back there. Everything that we need to live is in here.
That is awesome. That is well built, and that's just like a typical basement that an RV actually has. Mm-hmm. So, but you just has yours. You guys could actually, if you guys were playing guitar, you could have a little stage.
Yeah.
Play some music.
He plays violin, so.
Earn some money on the road.
And it does, I don't know much about welding, or I would have done it again myself, but there is room if you know how to do this, and they do sell things to bolt under here. I didn't have the time before we left, I might. But there is room under these panels here. So if you did want to add something like an RV has under here, storage, water, whatever, there's room. You just need to find a way to fix it to the underside, and there's plenty of bolt holes up there. Plenty of things to go into. I just didn't have the time.
So how many watts is that?
I have two 100-watt panels up there, and I have an MPPT solar controller. They're a little bit more expensive. They're actually quite a bit more expensive than the average PWM controller that you guys are gonna... If anyone's looking into solar panels, you'll see PWM and MPPT within 2 minutes, and you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. I would go with MPPT. Everyone's gonna recommend it. They're right. It's so much more efficient. These 200-watt panels are about the same as what I would get with 400-watt panels if I was running a PWM. So I would definitely go MPPT, and they're easy to install. They plug in really easily. The hardest part for this was finding a way to affix them to the roof, but as far as the electrical component of them, they're a breeze.
Cool. So how do you like living off of alternative energy?
It's nice. It's a good feeling.
Yeah.
I'm like a very environmentally conscious person. Like, I try to just reduce my waste where I can. Like, I don't like to buy a lot of like packaged goods because it just like produces a lot of waste, and I feel like a lot of people get into the habit of only buying packaged foods, and then you have all this extra plastic, and like, it hurts my heart. So, anyway, it feels really good not having to like depend on you know, being grounded somewhere to get electricity. It's nice to be able to just depend on the earth's resources without being like wasteful or, you know, like we've had to be really, really resourceful and like not use a lot of water because like we've been going on trips and sometimes we go days where like we don't have access to water. So it's, you know, it's a different lifestyle, but it's great. I like it.
Very cool. Well, awesome. If you guys do end up having any kind of YouTube channel, please let me know and I will link it to this. But thank you guys so much for the interview.
Thank you.
Definitely.